somebody was right about the lights up here. What a beautiful introduction. I'm telling you, everyone should have Angel Zambrano in their corner. You are a force of nature, a terrific litigator, and a dear friend. I thank you for your support and your very kind words. Thank you also to Dina for the nomination. I want to congratulate Veronica, Justices Garcia, and Nowell, Raha, and John. What a thrill to share the stage with you tonight. And Veronica, I really enjoyed your words. Also, congratulations to the Dallas Association of Women Lawyers, the Dallas Women Lawyers Association. You guys have grown so much. I remember when I was in law school and I got my first invitation to a happy hour, and I think the membership was somewhere in the dozens. So this is a tremendous success and a tribute to your work this year. You don't receive this type of award in a vacuum, and I certainly don't accept it that way. Being a lawyer is a team sport, and that's never more true than when you're in-house. To my friends here from AT&T, and there are many, this is an award for our department, and I accept it with that spirit. The Dallas Women Lawyers Association creates a place for women to be mentored, to feel empowered, and to be supported. That's how I have felt my entire career, and I feel very fortunate in that. Early on, I was mentored by tremendous lawyers at Carrington Coleman, including Jim Coleman, now Judge Lynn, Monica Lattin, David Cole, Kathy Altman, Kelly Henson, I saw you here earlier today, and all of my good friends at that firm. They saw something in me as a young law student that I didn't yet see in myself. They taught me to be the lawyer that I am. But they showed me how rewarding a career can be if you care more about others than yourself. I've been empowered by many, but tonight I'd like to recognize David McAtee for helping me see the leader that I could be, and for time and again in my career, giving me the opportunity to do more, to be more. To AT&T and John Stankey for the environment that you're creating, where everyone has an opportunity to not just be successful, but to thrive. Thank you both for your presence. I've been supported by so many, certainly those that I work with now, currently Joe Tocco. You challenge me, you inspire me, you motivate me, you empower me, and usually that's before breakfast. And I love every minute of it. To the tremendous lawyers and legal professionals at AT&T who joined us here tonight, Daryl and Leisha, Bill and Stacy, Taylor, Amy, Vinay, Tim, Sarah, Meredith, Errol, Paul, Altricia, my first boss at AT&T, Rod, Melissa, Jean, Kate, Heather, and Vicky, I saw you, I haven't gotten to say hello. You make me a better lawyer, and you make me a better person. It's my greatest honor to work with you, and I thank you for taking the time out of your schedules to be here tonight. We are all supported by outside counsel. I already mentioned Angela and Monica, but I know Don Estes is in the room, Sean Cleveland, and Sylvia Cardona, my good friend, who flew in from San Antonio to be with us. You always have our back, and you make us look good, and we couldn't do it without each of you. There's a community in this room of like-minded servant leaders, individuals from the Dallas Association of Young Lawyers, the Texas Young Lawyers Association, the State Bar, DWLA, of course, attorneys serving the community, Community Partners of Dallas, the Texas Bar Foundation. Individuals from these organizations have impacted my life by giving me the opportunity to serve. There's also a unique group of women. Veronica, you call them the You Got It Girls. I call them the original Girl Pack. But whatever you call them, you think of them as your board of directors, your counselors, your life coaches, your fun enforcers. So Dina, Shelby, Rachel, Cortland, Penny, Peggy, who's off in India, Jenny, Kellyanne, you are extraordinary women, and you've enriched my life. And of course, supported by family, my father-in-law, Jim Morris, who we lost last year, who insisted on me valuing myself, who would resist if I said that my success was because of luck. He would say, no, the harder you work, the luckier you get. My mother-in-law, Dorothy Morris, and my brother-in-law, Stan Groom, both are here tonight. Thank you. And Thomas, who nurtures me and who nurtures a lot of people in this room. None of this happens without you, Thomas. And I'm so happy to share this life with you. So thank you. Thank you for touching my life in a meaningful way. And in thanks, I will continue to mentor and empower and support women for generations to come. And I'm so very thankful that DWLA gives us the platform to do just that. Thank you.